Good morning and Om Shanti to all of you listeners. And today is the 168th day of your godly blessing. Before we go ahead, have a look at the video link above. 11 videos, fitness, diet, sleep, and yoga asanas for your flexibility. Have a look at them and share them with others. So let's go ahead with the blessing today, 168th day of blessing. And Baba is reminding us about one big weakness which all of us souls have, and that weakness is to look at the weakness in others. Yes, that is also a weakness. We think that when we are pointing out towards somebody's weakness, we are trying to help them out to see that they are bad in some manner and they need to change. God says, if you do that, you are first of all making yourself weaker. You're first of all making yourself impure. So then what do we do? God says there's another method. That's why He's God, and we are His children who have forgotten the method. So let's see what Baba has to say in today's blessing. Baba says, may you be a master bestower and do not look at anyone's defects or weaknesses, but cooperate with your virtues and powers. That's the answer. Now, let's get into the details. How do we do that? How do we not look at somebody's weaknesses, but at the same time, help them to find ways through the powers and virtues which we show them? So, a master bestower means constantly to have the spiritual feeling that all spirits, in bracket, souls, should claim a right to the inheritance just as you have. So a master bestower, somebody who's a giver, somebody who donates in the world also, when we see somebody who's donating lakhs and crores or millions and billions of money for making poor people happier or comfortable, or they're giving any form of tithe, which we say in religious terms, for doing any form of service, we say that person is a bestower. But God says the master bestower is somebody who gives something which can never be taken away. So if you give money, it will finish off. If you give food, it will finish off. But if you give the powers and the virtues to souls and help them to see how to live a life, then they can better their life. So God says something which you can give out of your bank in the physical terms will deplete. But something which you give through your thoughts and powers and virtues will never deplete. It's like you first having to generate those thoughts in your mind. To have virtues, you have to think humility. You have to think peace. You have to think peaceful thoughts. You have to think loving thoughts. And when you do that, whose stage goes up first? Yes, your own stage goes up first. You become more peaceful. You become more pure. You become more happier. And then when you transmit that vibration of give those thoughts or speak those words, is giving something which will never finish. That soul, when that soul listens to that peaceful word, that happy word, or that happy knowledge, or that knowledge of power or strength, then that soul will remember that forever. But that money which you give will finish off, and that soul will forget it about it. So that's why we say in this world, I have done so much for this person, I gave so many gifts for this person, I gave so much of money to this person, but this person doesn't recognize or realize or accept that, yes, when we give words of love and peace and happiness, that has a long-lasting impact on people than the amount of money or the gift which you gave to that person. Think about it again. So Baba says, should claim an inheritance, right to the inheritance, just as you have. What is inheritance? God gives us the knowledge, the peace and the power and the right method to think. If we give that and donate that to other souls, then it increases in our own life also, even before it goes on to somebody else. It's like it's passing through us. So His light, His vibrations pass through us, and that's the only method for everlasting love and peace in your life. I'm experiencing it, you can experience it too. So Baba then says, let's go ahead. You do not look at anyone's defect or weaknesses. We generally complain in a family also. My father is like this. My son is like this. My mother is like this. This person is never going to change. This person is so lazy. This person doesn't do his work on time. He doesn't get up on time. He doesn't sleep on time. He's always lazing around. He's always postponing things. And we keep on complaining and complaining. Do you think that you are making that person, that soul, stronger? No, actually you're making yourself first weak. Your own purity is going away. You're trying to act God. By the way, God doesn't look at somebody's weaknesses. So saying that you're trying to act God is also not right. You are trying to be somebody who's a judge in place of God. Yes, God is the last judge. But if you try to judge people now, you're not God. that you have so much of power to see somebody's weakness and still be not affected. Because when you see somebody's weaknesses or somebody's defects, you first deplete yourself of purity. You first make your mind unstable by looking at those weaknesses. So stop doing that. Stop bringing the negativity to yourself first, because again, it's passing through you. So if you create thoughts of weaknesses and defects in your mind regarding somebody, it's going to pass through you to that person. So what are you giving? Are you giving a blessing or a curse to that soul? So if you give a curse out to that soul, what comes back to you? The curse. The first curse is you creating those negative thoughts in your mind. When you're looking at somebody's weakness or defects, you're first creating, or you're first cursing yourself. You're depleting your peace, you're depleting your love, you're depleting your energy. And then what do you give? You give depleted love. Then there's conflict, then there's fight amongst each other. That's what God says, stop doing that. So, you do not look at anyone's defects or weakness, but give the cooperation of the virtues and powers. Let's say somebody is not able to get up on time. What do? You do the same. You start getting up on time and show them how it is done. Instead of saying, get up on time, you're always lazy, you're always doing this, you don't sleep on time, you don't work, you don't do things on time. Don't do that. Why? Because you are creating your energy of negativity and you're depleting your purity. So your willpower is reducing. Tomorrow you'll start doing the same mistakes. You won't be able to get up on time yourself. You'll get up on time maybe through ego, but after a couple of days you won't be able to get up on time because you're focusing too much on somebody's weakness. And when you do that, that becomes a part of you. Yes, soul as a thought which cannot be seen but can be imbibed very quickly. Yes, physical money, you see it coming to you, right? In your bank, on your hands. But this is something which is an income which can be increased, and you will never know it's getting increased, whether it's negative income or positive income. If you're creating thoughts of purity, if you're looking at the good in others, you're increasing a positive income. But if you're looking at the negativity and defects of others, you are creating a negative income. But you cannot see that income coming. You can feel it coming. How? You'll feel sad throughout the day. Your moods will be swinging throughout the day. You won't be feeling happy. You'll feel as if something is less, something is lacking me. And what is lacking? Lack is that instead of giving virtues and powers to other souls and showing them how to be peaceful and loving, you're rather showing them that they are weak, that they have so many defects in them. And that is what is going to make you peaceless and make you completely drained out throughout the day. So, Baba says that instead of having the feeling that that one is always like this, this person is always like this, this family member is always like this, this person in my business is always like this, my business partner is always like this, or this subordinate is always like this, I give him work and he doesn't do it, he doesn't come on time. Stop. Don't do that. That one is always like this. Let there be the pure feeling. Let me make this one the same as the Father. Let me guide the soul to make that soul the same as the Father. Means to have the virtues and the qualities and make that soul change. But for that, stop complaining, stop finding defects, stop finding faults. Do it first yourself with love and care and humility. And what do you do more? You come and learn it at Brahma Kumari's, the complete method of how to go about it. Then you slowly practice it and you change your behavior of looking at weaknesses and defaults and defects in others. It happens over a period of time. You can do it instantly also if you're a powerful soul, if you are a meditating soul, or you'll take some time. So that's up to you. So let there be the pure feeling. Let me make this one the same as the Father. Along with this, you should have the elevated hope that from being poverty stricken, souls are poverty stricken, not just physical poverty, but souls. Spiritually, they're drained out. They have gotten into the habit of looking at weaknesses, defects, negativity, impurity. They are into lust and anger and greed and jealousy. Every soul is poverty stricken. God says a soul who has money but doesn't have virtues, doesn't have values, doesn't have character is the poorest soul in the whole world. Imagine. So you can be somebody who doesn't have enough money but can be the highest and the purest soul and the virtuous soul in God's eyes. Have you ever thought like that? Think about it again. We think that having money is something which God is giving us. And that's why he's blessing us. God says, I give you virtues and powers. You do your karmas on the basis of that and you gain. If you're getting black money or negative source of money, then you might have a lack in your bank account. but you'll have multifold amount of tensions and stress in your life. Think about that also. So God doesn't give you money. God just teaches you the virtues and values. So that black money is not given by God. That's your karmas which are getting it. You can't say God gave me the money. Sorry, that's wrong. So God says, souls are poverty stricken, unhappy and peaceless. Let all souls be constantly peaceful. Let's have that great and beautiful blessing towards them. Happy and full of all treasures. You will then be called a master bestower. If you think like this for everybody, instead of looking at the weaknesses, you have a good wish for them and you show them the method by not complaining, by not taking or picking up weaknesses in them, but by showing how not to be weak by doing it yourself first with values, virtues and powers. So I leave you with this beautiful vartan, a strong, powerful vartan. Have a blessed day. Stay safe. Stay home. Om Shanti.